been chosen because we're special or extraordinary or unique in any way. It's because we're completely blank. We're just a vessel. People can project whatever they want onto us. We could be anyone. We barely even have personality. We're just another bland, faceless pawn being pushed through the cynical, capitalist machine. And we fall on Fripp because we're stupid. We're even more stupid than they thought possible. They stand up and look down at us. But the thing they hate most about us, they explain, besides the fact that we align to everyone, is the fact that we align to ourselves. What is that habit we have of wriggling out of responsibility? Of never owning up to our wrongdoing? Of pretending to be part of a community, a collective, when really we are a grubby, craven, clawing individual? That's right, an individual, and the sooner we admit it to ourselves, the better. And we're only here for the money? They spit. Something happens when they say that. Some little switch gets flipped, and all of a sudden we're on our feet. We're shaking with rage. Actually physically shaking with it. Who the hell do they think they are? They look taken aback. Shocked. They weren't expecting us to fight back. Do they know what it's like not to have it? To see it everywhere, but to never, ever, ever get to touch it? How low and poor and pallid it makes you feel, the way it erases you. We start to reply, but now it's us holding up our hand. They will listen. Just look at them, we say. All their life, they haven't even had to ask. They've just been given, 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 and now look at them, throwing a tantrum because for once, they've taken away from them. So right. Now they know how it feels. Now they know what it does to a person to be without. And yes, we want money. We admit it. We crave money. We will do anything for money. Even fall in love. If that's what the world asks of us, then so be it. We didn't make the rules. It's people like our friend that did. And we are just the poor fools who have to play the game. Keep on, till it's a turn around, it's a tiny crop of what they've always said, right. We're amazed at how powerful we feel. We turn and we stride away from them, puffed up with rage and pride and righteousness and oh crap. They beckon us into a little room, and inside that room is a telephone.